So I got a sort of a late start this week, but a couple of good things happened. I got into the second class, second out of five classes that I really wanted to take. Took the first one, finished it about 2 weeks ago now, and I really want to take the entire course. So what happened is that I got financial aid for the second course as well. Started 2 days ago. Already sort of delved into it. And that's completely irrelevant to what I'm doing here on YouTube. It has to do with what I studied in college, which wasn't art or anything artistic related, other than some advanced coloring we called it. It was a geology degree. So I have been sketching a little bit. Not in my big book, not in my big sketchbook, in my little one. But I have been doing that. So even though I'm not using it right now, it's done its job. It forced me to start sketching more, which is great because there will be new content coming in here on YouTube in terms of my speed paintings, and the Patreon stuff and all the things around that are close to being finished. Still tinkering with the final introduction video. That's something I tend to do. One day I might think it's finished, and the next day I start thinking about other stuff. Usually before I go to bed, that's where my mind is just flooded with ideas and things. You know, things that I really want to make into reality, that I really want to happen. And but that's fine, because in the end, I'm really satisfied with the final product. So, another good thing is that I've noticed lately my review videos have been getting quite a lot of views, or significantly more views than my other vlogs, which is okay. So, all of you drawers, inkers, sketchers, painters, artists out there, if there's something you'd like me to review in terms of art supplies and things of that nature, shoot me a line, let's jump on the wagon, and I'll make something happen. If that's what you're interested in, I really enjoy doing these comparison and review videos. So right now, I'm gonna go to Corona to scope out one of the soccer complexes or parks with soccer fields on it. Because here's the problem. Around here in Riverside, there's a bunch of parks like that. But none of them have soccer goals or means to practice any meaningful sort of skills. It's sort of just go into a park, kick the ball around. Well, I'm gonna look out for an actual field where I can shoot the ball around and practice some free kicks and whatnot. I found a few spots here, but they always want you to pay. Now, that's not unheard of, but one of the complexes here that has the artificial grass and everything, it's pretty large. They want you to pay some like $20 an hour. They don't want individuals or people without a permit to just go and use it because of wear and tear. I'm sorry, but last I checked, the life expectancy of the artificial grass was like 20 or 30 years. Anyway, so I found this place in Corona. From the looks of it, it just seems you can just walk in and they have a bunch of fields with soccer goals already on there. So I'm gonna go check it out. If it doesn't work out, I'll keep looking. I just had to stop at the gas station, put some air into my tires and throw a little bit of diesel. But now we're ready to go. Best thing about it is they have goals on them. No nets, but goals. So I'm thinking about purchasing a soccer net so I can just come here and put it on one of these goals and just practice away. But that's a good thing that a park like that even exists nowadays, because like I said, all of Riverside is just pay, 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 you know. And It's not a small dollar. And I don't know. I think something like that should be definitely possible. You know, because not everybody has the time to join a team. I mean, I've done that in the past, but then the minute I join, I get called back to work, and obviously I can't play. The other time I joined up, and my team got kicked off for fighting. So, I'm definitely going to be more careful about choosing a team in the future if I choose to do so. But for now, we got this. Because here's the thing, my entire life was basically centered around sports, predominantly soccer. Come high school, I did track and field. Actually, years before that, I did a lot of athletics too. So, for someone like me, it's really important to stay in it. And once I got out of high school, everything was up to me. So college, I attempted to play for the college soccer team, but it was clashing with my classes way too much. I'd still be at school if I chose to play on the soccer team. I got on it, practiced with them a little bit, but then they changed the coach, and it just became too tricky to even attempt a college soccer career. So I let that one go. I still participated in intramurals and all that jazz, but so I managed to stay in it. But it's just once I graduated college, it becomes even harder and harder for adults to join any sort of league, and generally you have to pay for it. Over the years, I had to come up with ways how to stay on the competitive level, or basically stay in the game. Pardon my pun. It's definitely possible with places like that. Definitely is. And that's important. And that's important for me because I love sports. I always played sports, and probably always will till I die. And I supplement it with working out, conditioning, and that sort of stuff. Because when you're part of a team, high school, college, what have you, even adult league over here or anywhere else, all that's taken care of. You have your practice and training days. You know, you have coaches. They all take care of it. But if you're on your own, you basically have to manage all of it. And it's up to you whether you show up to work every single day. You want the results, you have to put in 150%, always show up and give it your best effort. But what I'm saying is that once you're entirely on your own, you're on your own. And you got to be an excellent manager of your own time. For somebody like me, I like to do that, but I still sometimes I see myself slacking off, and every now and then it's fine. I mean, anybody procrastinates a little bit, but you have to try just that little bit harder to make it. You know, set up goals so you feel more accomplished once you achieve them and once you attain a certain level. So that's my life story, and it's over now.
Thank you.
My calves are killing me right now. I did the calf workout last night, and I can barely stay and launch off my tippy toes right now, so I'm suffering, but it's for a good reason. Practice session, kept it kind of short and easy just because of the calves. I know they're gonna be punishingly painful tomorrow, but I mean, there's nothing like it. The feeling of a really good workout, all the pain, all the burn, all the mobility in your muscles, and then you get to stretch it. That's a lifestyle. I mean, you gotta love it. That's self-loathing called working out for you. All right, so I'm getting kind of hungry, finally. I haven't had lunch today, just a few little snacks to hold me over. Oh, where are my keys? So now I'm ready, thirsty as hell too. I'm ready to head back. So I'm definitely glad that I found this location. I mean, I always knew this park was here, but then I wasn't sure if they had the goals and all the amenities and everything. Like I said, the net is needed just so I can take the workout to its full potential and just, you know, kick away, practice free kicks, all that kind of stuff. And, but nevertheless, I mean, there's a huge amount of open space. I mean, you got all the freedom in the world over here. Something that I can do in my town, and this is only 11 miles away, so really no harm done. But like I said, oops, today is just about done. Now I get to go home and work on all the different projects that I started that need to be done ASAP. But that's another thing that I love doing, right? You gotta keep yourself busy somehow. All right. So I need to make another trip to the vet because Mitten's here. Decided to get herself another hematoma. This time on the other ear for a change. That was already messed up because she had a chunk bitten out of it or something like that. This happened Friday, late night. Yeah, late night Friday. That same day, I didn't notice anything on her. But about 10 o'clock at night, like, her ear again ballooned up, filled up with blood and all that stuff. So I didn't notice her scratching violently or anything, but we know what it is. It's another hematoma. It's going to have to be surgically taken care of, drained, and sutured together. So, yeah. Just in case. We really don't want to just let it go and let it heal on its own because she's a dumbass, and I just fear that she's gonna like bop it open or scratch it too bad or something, because right now it's bugging her, it's too heavy, and she keeps shaking her head, and like I said, she's a dumbass.